Hello everyone, SP Architects here. Here is another stair tutorial for you, which is a suspended stair. This is a very interesting stair because this stair is actually in the air and holded with these structural lines. I think it's quite cool and I have already done a bunch of tutorial on stairs so far. So if you want to check out my any of these ArchiCAD stair tutorials, check out the links in the description. Alright, let's get into the tutorial. Here we are in ArchiCAD. At the first, we are going to change the unit system from Project Preferences, Working Units. Click this millimeter, click centimeter, and click OK. We need a slab first for our stairs. Click the slab tool, change structure to simple, make a simple rectangular slab like this. Let's zoom in and go to stair tool now. Click that. We have this stair start and end. Let's click this one for the end. For the start, let's leave it as is. And create something like this. Alright. Once we have done, let's go to the story settings. Right click. And we are going to change the height. I prefer 330 centimeters. Click OK. We have a warning because we have changed the height of the floors. Just ignore that and click the stair. This is going to be a flying stair. So at the first stair, we are going to make this as 1/3 height, which is 17.5. Actually, we have changed the number here. But if you want to see the whole number, let's go to the working units. From here, make decimal 1, as you can see here. And click OK. Now we can see further above the comma. And I want to end the stair at the second story. So input here 0 and open up the stair parameters. And also you can hit Ctrl plus T. For the desired thread number, we are going to make this 19 or 18. We can leave this one as is. For the width, let's make this 110. As for the thread width, to fix that, we are going to make this both same, which is 30 and 30 here. Once this is done, they will be fixed at the 13. Now we need to change some structure type here. Under the structure, this flat structure, click this cantilevered, and also as for the landing structure, cantilevered. And let's go to flight. Change this one to do this type of flight block. Actually, this is a kind of structure type. It enters the wall and holds the stair and also holds the finish materials. But we are going to use this for decorative purpose. By the way, we have changed the thickness to the 5. And let's go to the finish and uncheck finish. So we don't want to see any finish material. We only want to see structure material. Let's go to the 3D and look at what we have. As you can see here, we have these structure elements and also the parts that will enter the wall. Alright, let's go to the floor plan and moving on. Let's create a simple wall and let's see what will this look like. For the structure type of the wall, click the simple and create a wall like this. It also extend this part. There we go. Let's go to the 3D. And here we can see how the structure part was entered to the wall. This is a kind of stair shape and design, and you can use this one for your design, of course. But if we come back to the title of this video tutorial, we are going to use this one. We are going to use this metal plate, and for these settings, just check up these boxes, make the thickness 0.8, and we are going to change the material from this representation. Check up this one, click this metal stainless, open that up, and we can use this dark gray, or maybe anthracite color will be more elegant. We can click OK. And let's see what we have. There we go. Not bad. Let's just get rid of this wall. And now we need to have something to hold this stair in the air. Therefore, let's go to the ground floor. Click this ground floor. Copy to the first story. Ctrl plus V. Right click. Click OK. Once we have done this, click the floor. Click this edge. Click minus. And make an opening for the stair. With this rectangular. You just make a rectangle shape in the slab and you will have an opening. Also, you can use these offset edges. By the way, we need 4 cm for the wires, which will hold the stair in the air. We are going to use wires and that wires will hold the stair in the air. By the way, we can change the material for these floors to the light gray. Okay, now this seems better. Let's go to floor plan and make a simple section because we need to see some details. Right click this section and open that up with current view settings. Zoom in and here we have these problems and we are going to fix that. Ctrl plus T, go to the settings from here, click this corner, click this uniform nosing and click OK. We can see that we have cornered noses and also we have this problem, stair entered into the wall. Therefore, we are going to move the stair to the left. There we go. We have fixed some issues, but we need another riser for starting point of the stair. We need to use some custom model for this. Therefore, we are going to use the morph tool. Let's pick up the morph tool and override the first thread of the stair. Once we have done this, we can give it some thickness. Click the face, click extrude and input the same value, which was 0.8. We can zoom in and try to select our morph, but we cannot. Oops, we have here this morph. And let's move it to the place, to the here. But maybe we need some more thickness or width. Let's just press this corner and go to floor plan. Make a selection if we can. Suspend group off. Okay, we cannot do that. Let's just make that manually. Click the edge and offset 0.8 and also 0.8 again to the same place. But maybe we need 0.2 centimeters more and also this one. There you go. Now this was aligned to the correct place. By the way, we can uncheck this cover fills and change the structure type as same as with the stair, which was, let's look into that. Click structure and it says steel structural. So we click the morph and click this steel structural and now they are the same. After that, we are going to change the material to anthracite. But as you can see here, we have color difference. So we have to change the color because one of these is brown and this is blue, which is tan color is 90. So we are going to make this 92. Input here 90 and also here. There we go. Now they looks at the same and undivided. By the way, we have added more thread, but upper floor is at the same place. So let's increase the size of this opening. Click the slab, click offset edge to the starting point of the morph. Alright, now we can make our structural wires. Let's go to ground floor and make a wire section with circle, which is going to be 0.5. Once this is done, we are going to fulfill with morph this one. Click the morph, hit the space and click that circle. Once you have done that, you are going to click the inside face of the morph. If we can, you click the face and click extrude and input 330, which was height of the stair. Once this is done, we are going to use array with control plus U. We are going to use the spread. As for the spacing, make 10 and vertical displacement is 0. Click OK and draw a line to the end of the stair. There we go. Select the first and mirror from the center. After we have done that, let's go to 3D. And this is what we have. Actually, it's quite elegant and we can use this as is. But further step is we are going to cut the downside of the wires. So let's click all of the wires. Right click connect solid element operation. Get target and click the stair and make operator. Click the stair and last street. Get operator elements subtraction with downwards extrusion and execute. There we go. This is a very nice, interesting, smart and elegant stair. That was all it for this tutorial. I hope you have learned something with this video and you can use these learnings for your designs and for your stairs. If you like this, please hit the like. It's going to help the channel growing up. And do not forget to subscribe if you want to see similar tutorials like this. Until the next tutorial, have a nice day.